Am I on screen? Yeah. Good evening, everyone. Hope you are all staying safe. We have put together this talk along with our director, ma'am, Dr. Minishaji Thomas. Thank you, ma'am, for taking some time out of your busy schedule to give this talk to the students and the faculty who are attending this session, which we are very sure that will be enlightening. Aiding us in this, ma'am will be talking about how we can, as students and as the NIT Trichy community, effectively utilize the online semesters. And how can we best deal with the stress associated with the lockdown in better ways? And also, ma'am will take this opportunity to share some of her personal experience and help us understand how better how we can manage the stress with these continuous online classes and online exams. We are delighted to hear from you, ma'am. Over to you, ma'am.
Good evening, my dear friends from across India and maybe from abroad as well. I thank the Student Council for organizing this session. It's wonderful to talk to the students. I wish I could come to your classes and speak to you personally, which I used to do, you know, at least once a semester. I used to go to classes along with the Student Council representative and talk to each one of you in class. So we are missing the opportunity. Last semester also I missed. This semester also probably I'm going to miss it. I was just wondering, you know, because this would have been Festember times if it was normal routine. Last year we had Festember just after, you know, exactly this time. I miss the fun as much as you do. I remember the times when the likes of Gautam Menon, Santosh Shivan, Aruna Sairam were in campus. I miss the dance, music, and the dramas, the presence of all of you here. In fact, when I walk in the morning, I see the empty spaces everywhere, and it really makes me sad. I wish the students were around. You know, so the lockdown came out of the blue for all of us. I think all of you went home for a week or two, but then it has stretched to 6 months now. But we are coping with it. Thank you so much, Student Council, for organizing this. I think they have put some questions for me, made some questions for me. So I would wait for what they have to ask me, and then I'll be answering one by one as far as I can.
Sure, ma'am. Sure, ma'am. Thank you for the wonderful intro, ma'am. Now we have with us Atif, the PR and Media Cell co-head. He'll be asking the questions along with me in a podcast fashion. Over to Atif.
Hi, ma'am. Good afternoon. The questions we have are mostly sent. How we as students should go about dealing with our free time, our new change in schedule, how we should go about, you know, structuring our new time. So since the beginning of lockdown, ma'am, most of us were lucky enough to get away from campus and stay with our parents. And, you know, it's a very stressful time. You know, it's a time when you couldn't go out, you couldn't go about your regular schedule. So, ma'am, there were very few of us who were unlucky enough to be left in campus. And there were a few administrators that were left in campus. And I know that you, ma'am, are one of the few that were also in campus. How was it different for ourselves? How about improving ourselves? How do we go about that type of thing?
Yeah. Yes, it was very difficult because when the lockdown was about to start, or when the COVID started, we were too much focused on faculty recruitment. Although the students were busy with classes, we were busy with faculty recruitment in February and March. We had received around 4,500 applications, and out of which we were shortlisting, and you know, we had tests, and we were having interviews from middle of February, and we were about to finish the faculty recruitment when the COVID struck India. So we were taken completely unaware of the situation, and it came all of a sudden, you know, how to manage, because there were multiple things at stake. First of all, we had to take care of the safety of the students. Second, the safety of the campus residents, because we have 350 families living in the campus with older parents and young kids. So safety of the campus was of prime concern. So it was very difficult. And then how do you run the offices? Because we can't say that we don't pay salary to the staff. We can't say that, you know, my office will not receive letters. So it was difficult, especially the lockdown happened. We had only 4 hours to prepare ourselves for the lockdown. But thanks to the administration, my deans, the security officer, the medical team, the estate office, we managed very well, I would say, and the hostel administration, and of course, all the deans. So all of them cooperated. We put up a screening booth as early as 10th March at the gate to screen the people coming in. And although it was a little uncomfortable for the students first to realize that what is happening, but then it happened. And we ensured that everything is delivered at the doorsteps for the faculty and the staff who are residing. The messes kept running. And then we had to ask the students to leave because we just couldn't manage everybody here. After that, then we had to think of what to do with classes. So then we developed that online study material portal. And then, you know, then we started having the students to learn online. Then the lockdown extended. Then we thought of what to do with exams, etc., etc. So it went on. And then I think we did well because we had already automated our offices. You know, everything was online, although people were not using it. But when the lockdown happened, all the file movement became online. So wherever we are, we could clear the files and we could get things moving in the institute. So I think we are floating. And then we made all the research processes online, you know, all the DC meetings, the synopsis presentations, the PhD Viva, everything we went online. So that was, how we coped up. And then, of course, the students, we tried to do many things for students, although, you can't replace face-to-face teaching. So overall, I think we did well, as an institution, because we have been able to prevent the COVID mostly coming into the campus because we could, save the campus from COVID. I think we are better than other campuses in that respect. And the students also, cooperated. Yeah.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you so much. Ma'am, you had mentioned how we had, brought new changes forward. And the online semesters is one such change that many of us didn't expect. But now we have to, become used to it. So this online semester, ma'am, it's new for students, it's new for teachers. We have 15-minute classes, from morning till afternoon. And the breaks are very small. It's a new experience. There's very little peer-to-peer interaction. We don't have our clubs as before. So there's a lot of stress, there's a lot of anxiety. Students aren't used to this new structure, this new type of class. So any tips, ma'am, on how we should go about managing this? Any tips on how we should go about managing exams and everything else in this new online way?
How can we better reduce the stress that is associated with it, ma'am? We also have these assignments and placements. So how can we best reduce the stress? Like, what can we do, ma'am?
Yes, let me give our example also, then I'll come to students how you can do it. See, we were having all face-to-face meetings. We had very less time on the computers, only the emails and the associated things. But then, first of all, we also panicked a bit. How can we run things or learn things without face-to-face meetings like you do, because you are not used to online teaching or online classes. So we panicked a bit, but then we decided, okay, no, we will go online, for all the meetings. So in fact, we used to have 2 deans meetings every week. And we realized that it is much harder to do meetings online than meetings face to face. And I think you're facing exactly the same problem. It's much harder to have online classes than face to face. You have to do it because we have no alternative. Because everybody is doing around the globe. Even nursery kids are doing it. High school kids are doing it. Every college is doing it. We are a technical institute, so we have to do it. Now, how to overcome stress? I can tell you my experience when you think of the institute, if something happens, even if one case comes up, how will we handle it? In fact, I'll tell you, when the new faculty joined, 69 of them have joined, 68. So we had to quarantine them for 14 days. Our guest house became a quarantine center. We had to provide them food. And then finally, we realized one faculty who had traveled from north was tested positive. Then we had to isolate all the contacts. We had to isolate around 17 people, quarantine them wherever they were. So that stress was always on our heads, you know, what will happen if something goes wrong? But then what you need to do is you need to find some way to, you know, think differently in the sense that think of something you love most. For example, maybe you have something which you were doing when you were a child or when you were a kid, some hobby, something which you had forgotten. You know, why don't you think about it and start doing it for some time? For example, I was kind of completely stressed out in June, July, because from March, from February it's going on. February, March, faculty recruitment, then April, May, June, July. By the time of end of June, July, I was completely stressed out. I think I was on a verge of a nervous breakdown. And somehow when I was on the computer, I came across saying that there is going to be an online singing session by Malayalam artists, Malayalam singers. I started listening to that, and it actually brought back all my, the old songs I used to love when I was a child and I was a youngster. And somehow after 2-3 days of listening to that, I could de-stress myself, you know, and then I made it a habit that, you know, whenever I'm stressed out, listen to your old habits, whatever you used to like as a child. Maybe it was cooking, maybe it was gardening, maybe it was singing, maybe it was, talking to your old friends, something of that sort. So I think you need to find some way to unwind. And also another thing I must tell you is, even if it's at home, follow a routine. You have to follow the routine. Otherwise, the day just finishes and you are stressed out. You do something which you don't want to do, but you end up doing it and then you regret it. So after a while, it increases your stress. So please don't keep doing what you are not supposed to do. I think that increases your stress and then you are stressed out. For example, online classes, if you are attending, okay, you have to attend. I saw some questions. What are the issues with online classes? But then you have to de-stress somehow. And my point is, I know a lot of youngsters. I have two children who are young. So they use a lot of online time other than studies, which you have been doing already. Now, added to that, when the online studies also come, you are ending up spending almost maybe, 12 to 15 hours in front of your computer on your mobile phone, which is not good. So my suggestion is, if you are watching something, make it short programs. Because if you watch long programs, you will be addicted and you will be, forced to stay late and spend a lot of time in front of the computer. So on a weekday, if you have classes, if you want to watch a program, select the short programs. Don't start watching a serial or a movie because that takes a lot of time and you can't stop in between. So that is one suggestion. And pick up some habit which you will love. Maybe reading, maybe writing, chatting with your friends. Spend some time calling your grandparents. Talk to them, your old teachers. So these are the things I do, and I've found it successful that you can. Another thing which we did here is, see, do something for others which makes you happy. For example, we started NIT Benevolent Fund. You know, when we started having COVID, we thought of starting a fund because a lot of people lost jobs due to COVID. So can we help people who are helping the campus in some way? So we donated some money, we help. You are student, you cannot donate money. But you can do so many other things. Talk to them, pray for them. You know, so when you do something for others, you feel happy. This is another way of de-stressing. Because we started a prayer group, all religion prayer group in the campus on 4th April. And today is 180 days we have been praying from morning 6 a.m. to night 10:30 p.m. Somebody is praying for 30 minutes. So that keeps you going, you know, somebody else is praying for me. So we can do that, you know, pray for somebody, help somebody, which will keep you a little de-stressed. I don't know whether it appeals to students, but this is what we have been doing. Yeah.
Yes. Thank you. Thank you, ma'am. Just adding on to this question, ma'am, can you just tell us, like, how can we best utilize these online semesters? Like, how can we, you know, best make good opportunities of these online classes that we have, and, you know, best handle these exams and the placement process that we have so far? And how can we work on ourselves, especially, you know, because there are not much extracurricular activities that we can do now. So can you tell us how can we best utilize this online semester in terms of, you know, the achievements that we can look into, some opportunities we can tap into?
Okay, one thing I want to tell you, online classes, if you're finding it difficult to concentrate, what you should do is you should start taking notes. I think when you're attending online classes, probably you are not taking down notes, thinking that, you know, the PPTs are there or the recording will be uploaded, things like that. But if you want to be attentive, you have to take down notes. And I'll tell you how I used to study, because I was a topper all through my life from my school. BTech first rank holder, M.Tech first rank holder, but I was never a bookworm. I was always an all-rounder. I used to participate in everything, but I was always first in my class. My secret is I was very attentive in class and my notes were perfect, you know. So if you can take that habit, you take down the notes, you will automatically become attentive. And don't let the teacher move forward if you have not understood. And I think best way to ask questions and best opportunity to ask questions is when you are having an online semester, because you are not face to face with the teacher. You should be confident enough to ask. So don't let the teacher move forward if you haven't understood a concept. So take down notes. That's my request to each one of you. And what I used to do was, before going to the next class, I will read my notes once. So I was ready for my next class. That's the only thing I did. And I used to top my class. So that's my tip to you. If you want to be attentive, please take down notes. Sure. And best utilize the semester is, if you are, you can't do anything else. So why not concentrate on studies and do some other online courses? Because I was reading about a girl who did some 30 courses during the 6 months of lockdown. Because, and I can also tell you, this time our M.Tech admissions is almost full. Everybody is going to study. So you are in for tough competition. So unless you study hard, make yourself more competitive, it's going to be tough. So you have to concentrate, take down your notes, and try to learn.
Sure. Thank you, ma'am. And just one more question, ma'am, that is there on everyone's mind right now, is that among all this uncertainty and ambiguity, when can we expect the college to reopen, ma'am? Like, and can you tell us the steps taken to bring back the students in campus, if there's a possibility?
Yes. For us, one problem is we are a residential institute. We are not an institute where students come and go. If students were coming from home and going back, we could have started classes with social distancing. But our problem is 95% or even more than that of our undergraduate and postgraduate students are residential students. So for residential students to come back, there are norms. Like if you're coming, we have to quarantine you for 7 days or 14 days. And then we can't let you go back home once you are here for a few months. And till now, the ministry has not taken any decision on reopening of colleges. Yesterday, the order came from Ministry of Home Affairs, which only talks about PhD scholars, research scholars. So our first priority will be to bring back the research scholars, which are small in number. So maybe we started from 16th October, batch by batch of 50, bring them, quarantine them, send them to the labs, but with an undertaking that they will not go back home for a few months, because we cannot again and again quarantine them. And the problem with the pandemic is younger people are not symptomatic, but they may be infected. They may not be symptomatic, but they will infect others who are seniors like us, and the parents and the children in the campus. So, and if something happens, everybody will blame us. Why did you call the students back? So being a residential campus, we are going a little slow. So whenever, and we are in constant touch with the Trichy collector also. So his viewpoint is also that being a residential campus, we have to be extra careful. So right now, I can't give any guarantee as to when we can come back, bring you back. But we will be most proactive. We are ready. If some directions come and if we see that the pandemic is receding, definitely we love to see you back in campus.
Understood, ma'am. And then one final question, ma'am. Just one question that was requested is that, can you tell us any new undertakings taken by our NITT during this corona time, any new undertakings, any new achievements that you would like the students to know about?
Oh yeah, I have lots to share. We should be very proud of the fact that during the pandemic, we got so many new opportunities. I'm very happy to tell you a few of it. I don't know how many of you are aware that this year, we are graduating maximum number of PhDs. Last year, we graduated 98 PhDs. This time, we have crossed 110 already. That is just the academic number I wanted to tell you. We have been granted a supercomputer. So we are part of the National Supercomputing Mission by Department of Science and Technology, Government of India. So we must be very proud, all of you. The supercomputer is being installed in Third Eye. It should have been installed by now, but because of the pandemic, it got a little delayed. But the supercomputer, a 650 tera flops supercomputer is being installed. So you can all be part of it. You can, every department student is free to use it. You can think of projects you can do with a supercomputer. That is one. Second is, we have been inducted into the Prime Minister's Research Fellowship. I'm sure some of you are aware of the Prime Minister's Research Fellowship, where a student can directly do a PhD with a stipend of 70,000 per month. So we are the only NIT to be included, and we have been allotted 16 Prime Minister's Research Fellowships this year. we have sent in applications. Let us see how many we get it. But it's a very prestigious achievement. Also, recently we got a mail from the National Research Development Corporation (NRDC) that they have selected 3 institutes this year to set up exclusive centers for intellectual property rights, and NIT Trichy is the only government institution they have picked up. So we will have an NRDC IPR center here in the institute. Today again I received a mail that when can we set up the office here. And another important announcement we got is we have been made the national MOOCs coordinator for UG and PG engineering programs. All of you know about Swayam portal. So on the Swayam portal, engineering programs are done by only NPTEL, that is the IIT consortium. So now we have been made a national MOOCs coordinator. So we can develop our own MOOCs, UG and PG programs. In fact, we have request to make 300 plus MOOCs courses for the Swayam platform. So and we are setting up, high-end recording studios, 3 recording studios and smart classrooms, et cetera, around 25 crores we are investing into the IT infrastructure. The supercomputer is around 20 crores. So these are some of the achievements we could do during COVID, which is actually setting us apart as an institution. Encouragement for our the efforts we put in, and it's very good for the students because supercomputer, then also the national MOOCs coordinator, you will get a chance, the NRDC IPR center. I think these are all very good for the students, and of course you're getting 69 new faculty to teach you. I'm sure some of them have already started teaching you.
Yes, ma'am. That is almost all of the questions, ma'am. If you would like to know, take some questions from the comments, we'd be interested, ma'am. Otherwise, from our part, we're done with the questions, ma'am. Thank you so much for taking the time for doing the session. We just look at the comments for if you want to just pick up any questions that you would like to answer, ma'am.
Okay. From the comments?
If you'd like, okay. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, let me just check if there are any. Somebody is asking, can we reduce the time of online classes? Okay. Yes, we have taken that request because everybody wanted to reduce the time from, 50 minutes to something less. We are taking it up with the HODs, but the request is in your class committee, you can always do it. And there was another question regarding, and we will be talking to the HODs that they don't overshoot the time, from 50 minutes to more than 50 minutes. Definitely that question I will be taking. And somebody is asking about NVDS, and I forgot to mention that we already inaugurated the AI and Machine Learning Center on 7 September. So we have 6 high-end servers, high-end systems along with the AI server from NVIDIA. 1.2 crores we have invested. It's in the old library center. By the way, the old library we are going to call it Chidiya. So we'll be, it's an acronym for, Center for Innovation and Activity and all that. We'll be putting up the board soon, but it is already installed and inaugurated there.
Sure.
Okay. Stipend MTech we are giving, what is the problem? I don't know. Last time, what about stipend MTech? MTech stipend we will be giving. Second year, no doubt, there is no problem.
Yes.
Increasing entrepreneurial skills in students. Yes, the NRDC center will be for increasing entrepreneurial skills. And one more thing we want to do is we will be organizing a lot of programs to increase entrepreneurship skills. And we will be encouraging students to do, we already have the CEDI, Center for Entrepreneurship Development and Incubation. And if students, if you have some products, we'll be definitely supporting them to make it into an industry, because that is the need of the hour. So whoever has any idea, we will be helping them to make it into a product. And three faculty have already registered companies recently. So if students wants to do it, we will definitely encourage. Pre-recorded classes. Yes, many people talked about pre-recorded classes. We'll be requesting the faculty to do that, so that you can have them and learn earlier. Why you not listen the voice of students? What did I not listen? Yes, go in very fast, please, given the time constraints. Can there be a relaxation? Okay. You're having more classes daily. Ask about exams. Too many questions. By the time I read, they are moving. Okay. Software skills. Okay. My teachers are going very fast paced given the time constraints. Can there be a relaxation on this? Okay, we'll take this up, because I will do a meeting with the faculty. Kamlesh, you please compile these questions and so that we can take it up with the faculty. Please ask faculty to use electronic board. Yes, let me tell you, we have allowed all the faculty to buy electronic pens and other gadgets for online teaching. They are in the process of procuring. Maybe in a week or two, all of them will have. We have given the permission to buy it. So I think they are buying it. You will have it soon. SPDC scholarship amount is being delayed. I'll find out. I don't know, but I'll find out. One final thing I want to tell you, that when you are stressed out, count your blessings. Take a piece of paper, write down your blessings. Think of other people who are less fortunate. Think of people who have more problems. When I visit a hospital or a place where people are, helpless, you count your blessings. At least you can walk around, you can see around, you have your parents. So count your blessings, write down some blessings on a page. Then you will feel good. Professors are arranging classes as per their own schedule. No. We have given a timetable. They cannot do it whenever they feel like. We have asked them to follow the timetable, but in the class committee, they can change the timings of some classes, but they cannot take it when and where they want. And free access to library. See, I had asked all the HODs to give the core textbooks, the core textbooks to the librarian, so that we can purchase ebooks. Kamlesh, will you please find out what is happening with that? I had told them 2 months back to buy online, ebooks for all the core courses, core textbooks for undergrad.
We have taken suggestions from the students also, ma'am. There'll be a meeting and they said they'll issue the books. Thank you so much for taking the time to address our concerns and questions, ma'am.
Yeah, there's one more question. What is the impact on placements? So I am happy to say that, 25 companies have already done online interviews. And you must thank us, especially the third year students. We could conduct your exams and make you ready for placements. And around 250 placements are already there, already offered. Why is the library not issuing books? They are issuing books, I don't know. Okay, is it remote access? We'll think about it. NVIDIA Center and Supercomputer. But supercomputer will take 3-4 months to get installed because, yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
And I think the student council should work with the government. I mean, you should all send requests to the government that, you know, they should make internet less costly for students. The laptops or whatever you want to buy less costly for students. Because when an institution buys, the GST is only 5%. I think same thing should apply for a legitimate student and also for internet connection. You should get less cheaper ones by the government. You can't do it, but the government.
Sure, ma'am. We'll take it up.
Yeah.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for your time. It was very useful and very refreshing for us, ma'am. We look forward to further interactions with you in the future, ma'am.
Yeah, thanks, sure. Anytime. I'm more than willing because students keep us happy and healthy, and we need students around. You know, so anytime you arrange, I'm willing to speak to students. And wish you all very very happy long weekend. Enjoy your weekend, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Let's remember our father of the nation who gave us the freedom.
Sure.
You know, when I travel around the globe, you don't realize when you're in India how lucky we are to be born in a democratic country like India with so much of freedom to live. And we owe it to the father of the nation and the freedom fighters. So, tomorrow is a national holiday. Please remember Mahatma Gandhiji and salute the freedom we enjoy. And please be safe. Don't take corona lightly. Be safe and hope to see you all back in campus soon. Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye. Good night.